special name. In Jesus' name we say amen. 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 God is so good, and he makes sure that there ain't no confusion, that his word is his word. Turn with me to Jeremiah 18. Because Jeremiah found out that it's God's word. And God has blessed us today with a word that we call in God's hand. Amen. You don't feel like singing, so you play hooky. Right?
Wow.
And go to another church. You was in God's hands the whole time. Ain't that right? You're struggling to find a word to preach. And God comes and gives you a word and places in the heart of a musician, and you truly know it was in God's hands the whole time. You got family members who feel like they've been broken and they can't go on and they don't know which way to turn. I want you to know even they are already in God's hand. You see, Israel was broke. They didn't know where to go. They didn't know what to do. So God called the prophet Jeremiah, as Jeremiah had been praying to hear a word from God. God sometimes said, I can show you better than I can tell you. So God told Jeremiah to go down to the potter's house. Go down and see the potter, and I will show you my word. So Jeremiah goes down, and the Bible says when he got to the potter's house, in 18 verse 3, behold, the potter wrought a work on the wheels, and the vessel that he made of clay was marred in the hand of the potter. I'm trying to tell you, marred just means you're broken. Marred just means you didn't come out right the way you were expected to come out. It means that things in your life have not been going according to plan as you planned it for yourself. It just ain't right that a mother should have to bury her child. That just don't seem right. It just ain't right that a child should have to lose their mother before they even reach 18. Some things just happen in this world that come down upon you and it just makes you feel broken, hurt, and full of pain. I saw a movie over the weekend, and what happened was this child died, and throughout the whole movie, everybody is talking about, well, it's God's will. And I couldn't help it. I'm wondering, who would serve a God that thinks it's a good thing to kill a child? I don't think that's God's will. I think that there are things in this world that happen. God says, in this life, you will have tribulation. He says the sun falls on the good and the unjust. The rain comes upon the just and the unjust. Sometimes you're suffering just because it's your time to suffer. Sometimes pain hits you just plain and simply because pain hits you. Don't blame God. God ain't putting you through hell. It's this world that puts us through hell. But you got to know, even when you feel broken, you are still in the hands of God. Even when, have you ever felt broken? Like, no matter what you try to do, it just wasn't going to work. Sometimes we feel broken because of death. It seems like it comes knocking on our door too early. And if you let it, it'll tear you up on the inside.
And having the outside going through all kind of pain and misery. Some of us, it don't take that much. It could be the death of a relationship. Lose somebody that you love. Let somebody you love start loving somebody else. Y'all ain't never been there? Let somebody you love fall out of love with you and start loving somebody else. Sometimes you feel like you can't even get up out of bed no more. Sometimes you don't even want to brush your teeth. You don't even want to wash your face. You just lay down in pain and misery and just wish it would all be over. Some of us, we get broken so bad because you walk into the job one day and they say, we eliminate positions and we gonna start with yours. And you don't have a job here anymore. Take this cardboard box, take this check, and security will be here to escort you out of the building. And you look and you're like, what did I do? Because if you know you deserve to lose your job, you can take it a little bit better. And they say to you, there is nothing that you did wrong. We just don't need you here anymore. Security will come. And so many people get broken. They don't know what to do. It's like you just had your heart ripped out of your chest, and the pain and the misery makes you want to just crawl up into a shell and just curl up into a big old ball. But look what Jeremiah saw. The power was making a vessel, and in the potter's hands, the vessel was broken. Even when you feel broken, you still in God's hands. Even when somebody don't love you no more, you still are in the hands of God. Even when nothing in your life ain't going according to plan, God says, I know the plan that I have for you. Plan not to harm you, but to bring you peace, to bring you prosperity. You might have a plan, but God wants you to know I got a plan for you. And because God has a plan for you, he keeps you in his hands. Even when you are broken. So God says, you feel broken? That ain't no thing. Stand still and know that I am God. You feel broken? That ain't no thing. All you got to do is pray. And if you got to cry, you go ahead and you cry. If you got to let it out with tears, God says, let it out with tears. I'll wipe every tear from your eye. In the hollow of my hand. All you got to do is stand. Don't go running. Don't go trying to get away. Know that you're right where you're supposed to be. Somebody walking on you, out on you, God says you're right where you're supposed to be. Somebody said, we don't need your services here no more. You're right where you're supposed to be. Somebody you love is dead and gone. God says you're right where you're supposed to be, so you can see the salvation of the Lord. So in the hands of the potter, God says, I am God, and I can take you, and I can make you all over again. You know, if you've ever really been broken, I mean, like where you thought the only way to get better was just to die and end it all. Or where you really thought that the only way to get better was just to drop out of sight. Because you were so ashamed to show your face anymore. And you just felt broken, like you couldn't go on. If you ever felt that way, put it this way, if you ain't never felt that way, keep living. If you ain't never felt like it was all over, there was no coming back, keep living. But when you know that you were broken, you were distraught, and felt like you were destroyed on the inside. When God decides to make a change in your life, the change is so glorious, the change is so awesome. You thank God that you went through what you went through. You thank God that you was broken just to know you was in God's hands all the time. You thank God that you was broken just because you know that God put you back together again. I'm trying to tell you, God says, sometimes you just need to be made over. Sometimes you just need to be made again. You must be born again. You must undergo a change. And sometimes when God changes you, you can stand up with a new conviction and you just simply say, I know I've been changed. I know your glorious image. I am wonderfully and fearfully made in the glory and the image of God. When you know you got a new walk, you know God has blessed you with a new way to talk, when you know that God has given you a new life to live, you're grateful and forever thankful that you are in the hands of God. Stand on your feet with tongue. We give God the praise. We give God the glory. We give God the honor. Because he keeps us. He keeps our souls so that we shall not go down to the pit. I don't know if you ever felt broken and useless, nothing good is going on in your life. Remember what God said to Jeremiah. The potter is making a vessel, and in God's hand, God is the potter. In God's hands, we are the clay. And without Jesus in our lives, we are useless. We are worthless. We are nothing but empty vessels who have come from the dust, from the dirt, and back to the dirt shall we all go. But when God has you in his hands, and God is making you into a vessel, that means God wants to use you. He doesn't want you to be an empty vessel. He wants you to be filled with the Holy Ghost. He don't want you to be an empty vessel. He wants you to be filled with his Holy Word. He does not want you to be an empty vessel. He wants you to be filled with his light, that you might allow your light to so shine that men will see your good works and glorify the Lord. That men can see and give praise and thanks to the one who has called you out of darkness and into his marvelous light. That you might be changed and made anew, that you might be born again.